Hello, I'm Mark and I'm back for my second blog here on Villefond. As you see, I'm back in the cabin swim. And so I'll tell you what I did and what I had. I fished for one night, and as always I fished two rods. Briefly, the reason why I only ever fished two rods is, for me, the third rod, I'd always put my first rod, you know, my favourite spot, and then I'd have my second spot, and the third rod was always just a bit of a random chuck out. And then I also believe if you do it right on one rod, you'll catch fish. So if you do it wrong on three or four or five, whatever rods, it won't make a difference. So I find that I fish better with two rods because I tend to then concentrate more on my rigs, my positioning. So I always fish two rods. So fishing two rods, one halfway out to the island. I think the island's about, I think it's 50 odd metres. I did range find it, but from this swim. So I'm fishing probably not even halfway to the island. Halfway, just the side of halfway. And on that rod I put my favourite rig, my sweet corn rig. Now, before I came, I was determined I'm going to fish properly. Because a lot of times I tend to have one fish and then I pack up and go home. Or if I have one fish, I then tend to put that rod back out because it's dark and I'm lazy. So I decided this time, bringing my A game, we're gonna try and catch some good fish. I spoke to my cousin Rob, he also does blogs and helps us with the lake. I spoke to him and I said, right, I'm bringing out my best rig and I'm gonna make sure I get, once I have a fish, I get it back out there again. So I came here with my best rig, which is a sweet corn rig, and I always use a size 8 hook. Don't need bigger hooks, I find, because the bigger the hook, the more metal work, it's more likely they're going to either spot it or sense it. So I go the smallest hook and get away with, and I always use a curve shank size 8, and inline lead as well, so they hit the heavy part of the lead. I don't use drop off leads, don't see the point. If you've got a good indication, then they don't have the time to use the lead to shake the hook. So that's roughly my setup. So I had one on the sweet corn rod straight towards the island, and I had another one on a solid PVA bag on a fake bit of sweet corn chucked out to the right where some fish had been spotted. Not by me, by my dad. When he'd been up here working, he noticed the fish started to move around. As I approached, I noticed a big fish spooked out the shallow bay, so really good signs that the weather's starting to warm up, this just starting to move around a bit, so I was quite confident. So I'll just point out that I am now recording this after I fished. I done my fishing, then I went home and I decided to come back and put together all the pictures and the videos. So I had the two rods out, set up, and always quite quiet, keeping the noise down, got them out, boated them out, and then at 11:30 at night, which is normally the case down the shallow bay, as I said in the first blog, they come down normally over night time. So at 11:30 at night I had an absolute screamer, just melted off. So I come running out, hit it, and it was on, so playing it in, and it came in relatively easy, and it actually turned out to be a massive fish. And when I see it in the net, it was really massively long. I eventually identified the fish as a fish called Dorian, and it weighed in at 53 pound 4 ounce, and it's got massively long, massive tail on this fish. Normally it's notorious for fighting really hard and taking ages to get in. So I thought the water temperature is still cold, obviously a bit sluggish still, so I put that fish back absolutely over the moon, messaged my cousin, said brilliant, I've had it. And I thought, hey, you know, I'm not going to put that rod out again, it's dark, I've had a brilliant fish, I'm happy. But as he pointed out, I'm here to fish, so might as well just quickly make the effort and get it out. I didn't have to get up the next day early or anything, so I could sleep in the day if I needed to, rest, whatever. So I made the effort. I retied a rig I got the boat, took it back out, set it all up again, and went back to bed. And then at 5 o'clock in the morning, the same rod, the sweet corn rod, went off again. And again, an absolute scream. It was so loud and such a one-toner that it took a few seconds in while I was asleep just to register what was going on. And I woke up and I thought, what's that noise? And then it registered what it was. It was absolute screaming run. So I ran out again, hit it was on. And that one fought ridiculously hard, just did not want to come in. And at night, on your own hand, these big fish, it's quite hard work. And eventually, I used to get it in. And again, it was another, it wasn't quite as long as I see, but it was so broad, I knew it was going to be another big fish. And it was a 46 pound 14, a fish called Lucy, which I think is quite a rare fish. And I think it's one I haven't had before, very pretty sure. So, absolutely buzzing. And then after that, both fish soaked the clothes I had. So, the second fish. So the second lot of clothes I had. So after that, I thought, right, that is definitely it. So at 6 o'clock, I took the dogs and I went home, absolutely over the moon. Hence why I didn't get a chance to do the vlog then. So I am now here again, and I'm going to do hopefully 2 nights because the season's just about to start, and then we're fully booked. So I'm not going to get another chance to get on. So I'm hopefully going to have something over the next 2 nights. Who knows? The weather has got a bit colder again, a bit more miserable, a bit more rain, but fingers crossed. Okay, well, hopefully see you for bog 3.